We are live from Sapphire Now 2018 in Orlando, Florida. I'm Michael Krigsman. I'm an industry analyst and the host of CXOTalk. And we're speaking with Tim Harris, who is the Chief Information Officer of Andeavor. Hey, Tim, thanks for spending some time with us.
Absolutely.
Tell us about Andeavor.
Yeah, we're a large refining, marketing, and logistics organization, primarily on the western side of the United States. We've got about 3,000 retail stores, 10 refineries, about 1.2 million barrels a day. We just acquired Western Refining last year, and we're in the process of integrating them now.
Now, I know that you've been undergoing a very large transformation, so please tell us about that.
You know, when we looked at our company, we looked at our goal to grow so aggressively, both through acquisition and organically. We didn't feel like our business was fit for purpose, but either the systems or the processes really weren't ready to support what we wanted to do. We've moved 100% to the cloud. We've got a new digital workplace that really changes the way that all of our employees interface with technology. And probably the most monumental change has been our change to SAP S4. So we're the first oil and gas company now running SAP S4, and we've been live about 2 months.
As you move to the cloud, what does that do to your processes and also to the mindset of the way people work and the way they relate to technology?
We were a fairly conservative company with some traditional process. And so now that we're in the cloud, we do have the ability to work from anywhere. We can access our data securely from anywhere. You know, you don't have to jump through a bunch of hoops and a bunch of extra passwords to get there. It's very secure, but at the same time, it's very seamless. So I think it's starting to drive a mentality that you don't have to be in the walls of the office necessarily to get your work done. At the same time, we're completely out of the capital game. We don't have to plan and invest a whole bunch of capital to do the technology kind of things that we want to do. So the speed to market is much quicker as well.
Was it hard to make the decision to move to the cloud?
When you do the math and really understand the way that it works, get over those initial fears of security, and in reality, we're more secure now than we ever have been, and in the cloud, so there are so many benefits and so much upside, it really wasn't that difficult.
And you say that it changed the mentality of people as well.
We don't have to plan as long. We don't have to wait 8 weeks to order some piece of technology and wait for it to hit the dock and then go plug it in. I mean, look, we still have some challenges around turning everything up as quickly as we'd like, but it's so much better than it was before. It's really a no-brainer.
It sounds like the expectation of the business is that IT is going to be faster than ever before.
We used to run our company on spreadsheets and PowerPoint presentations. Now the expectation is real-time analytics, real-time data, and real-time insights across the entire business.
And breaking down silos seems also to have been an important part of this.
With our SAP strategy, we wanted a single application that integrated the entire business. So now that we're fully integrated, silos don't work anymore. So in the old days where it was more of a best-of-breed model, one application per function, you know, people could work independently, and if data was wrong in one system, it didn't impact the entire business. So you could get away with it. There were still problems that we couldn't see, but you could get away with that. And now, end to end, from the initial contract entered in the system all the way through until we're collecting cash from the retail stations, if we're not working together and talking about the data and the way that we structure things from an end-to-end standpoint, we're not going to get our job done.
Tim, they say these days that data is the new oil. And since you are an oil company, what does data mean for you? And how are you using data differently, and how is it changing your business?
We're still going to always make our money from oil, so we're not selling data. But the point for us is it is the most critical thing that goes on. We believe that all things digital rest on top of data. So data has to be structured the right way, it's got to be cleansed the right way, and it's got to be managed the right way so that we can really get our insights. We believe that we can lead the industry in digital transformation, and it's 100% because we've taken the time to structure the data the right way. We've got our IoT sensors, you know, dumping data into our systems now and giving us insights in ways that we've never had before. So it is going to be the core of everything that we do.
So it seems like the data is the next frontier for delivering value through technology.
You know, as much as you want to jump into artificial intelligence and IoT and everything that digital promises, it simply won't work if the data structure isn't there.
So the data is the foundation for innovation. Is that too strong a statement?
No. For us, we use the term innovation and digital synonymously. And again, we believe 100% that everything digital relies on data. If there's no data, there will be no digital.
Can you give us some examples of what that means for you?
Yeah, so it's everything from really advanced business insights through analytics. We're using artificial intelligence right now to predict failures in the refineries. So we have thousands of sensors, and they've been there for years collecting data on average every 3 seconds. Now, historically, what we've done is we've looked at every data point, and if it was in spec, we would ignore it. If it was out of spec, a technician would go take some action. But now we believe that looking at every data point, whether it's good or bad, looking at every data point will really generate trends and allow us to see things that we never would have seen before.
How do you gather this baseline data? To do this, you have to have a lot of stored history.
And we do. So again, in our industry, we've been collecting this data for a long time. We've never had the computing horsepower to do anything with it, but we have the data. So the great news about oil and gas is, you know, everybody talks about IoT, and in many industries, the long pole in getting IoT stood up is developing your sensor strategy and implementing the sensors, and it takes a lot of time, and it's typically expensive. In our industry, we've had all that. So we've been collecting the information for a long time. For the first time now, based on our technology transformation, we have the ability to look at that data in real time. And again, we have years of history, so we can now use that history to create the models and predict the failures.
In a way, you have been preparing for this moment going back many years through good data hygiene and just the kind of data collection that you've needed to run your business.
That's right, yep.
Well, Tim Harris, CIO of Andeavor, thank you so much.
Good, thank you.